Now let's come back in the SOLVE 2013 papers. So we've been seeing in all the paper question papers, you compulsory have one numerical. So this will be for 3 marks, and the definition or differences may be for one mark, 2 marks. So please let us not take risk. Please practice all the numericals which I've taught you in so many new thumbnails where we have said numerical 1, numerical 2. Please practice all the numericals. Let us see. So in this particular question, as I said, whenever a numerical is given to you, try to write the formula. Very important, because that also carries marks. Write the given data, that also carries marks. Substitution, that carries marks. Solving the numerical as well as writing the units for the answer also carries marks. So let's state 18 grams of glucose. Okay, the formula is given to me. Weight is given, W2 is given to me. M2 is given to me, is dissolved in 1 kg water. W1 also is given to me, that is 1000 grams in a saucepan. At what temperature will the solution boil? Done. KB is given to me, boiling point of water also is given to me. This is boiling point of water. Let's see how to do. First of all, what is the formula which I should write? They have given me dissolved in saucepan, solution boil. That means I have to write the boiling elevation, boiling point formula. So let us write that delta TB is equal to KB into M. Because weight is given, I have to further write this delta TB is equal to KB into molalities W2 by M2 into 1000 by W. Now let us come back and substitute the values. And oh no, I have to write the values. First of all, given values. So given data. In this particular thing, is KB given to us? Yes, KB is given to me. 0.52 K, because this also carries marks, isn't it? So I have to write everything like this. Then W2, how much is W2? 18 grams. M2, 180 gram per mole. W1. Weight of solvent, that is given as 1 kg, which is equal to 1000 grams. Then what else is not given? What else should I find out? I have to find out at what temperature will it boil. That means I have to find TB. This is the boiling temperature, isn't it? Let's come back. That means I have two formulas. One more formula is, second formula is delta TB is equal to TB minus T0B, correct? So this is your formula where we have studied elevation and boiling point. Let's start with a numerical. First thing, delta TB is equal to how much I'm using this formula here. KB, how much? 0.52. What is W2? 18. What is M2? 180. What is this? 1000. What is W1? 1000 grams. Okay, this is given to me. So when I solve this, I get delta TB, which is equal to 0.052 K. First answer is over. I still have to find TB. So let us use the second relationship. This is your first relationship. Now in the second relationship, delta TB is equal to TB minus T0B. Yes, so what is delta TB? 0.052. I hope maybe this is not clear here. Okay, I'll write it here better. So A part, I'm calculating the second part. So delta TB is equal to TB minus T0B. Delta TB I already got, 0.052 is equal to, I have to find TB. T0B is already given, boiling point of pure water, that is water, 373.15 K. So TB is equal to 373.15 plus 0.052, which comes equal to, add both, you get 373.202. Okay, so this is one answer. So you're going to mark and finally write the answer. At what temperature? So at what temperature will the solution boil? You will write the solution boils at 373.202 Kelvin. This is your answer. That also carries marks. This also carries mark. Please note, you have to write it in the box. So let us come back and solve the part B of your 2013 paper. So basically, as I said, every paper you'll have a numerical. So more number of times you practice the numerical, it'll be easy for you to complete the solutions chapter. Don't simply study the definitions or, you know, graphs and just go like that. Numericals are compulsory in the chapter. Done. Let's see. Now here in this particular question, as I said, your formula carries mark. So first try to write the formula. How will you write? Just go through the thing which is given to you. They said determine the osmotic pressure. Okay, that means I have to first write the basic formula for osmotic pressure. Let's write that, because this is carrying half mark for the exam. Pi is equal to CRT. Done. This is done. Let me see further, should I write the next formula or not. Osmotic pressure of a solution prepared by dissolving 2.5 into 10 to the power of minus 2 grams of K2SO4. Okay. That means the W2 is given to us. How much in 2 liters of water? Volume also is given to us. 25 grams. Assuming that it is completely dissociated. So they've included the Van't Hoff's factor here, and they're giving you the information that your K2SO4, it's dissociating into 2K++SO4-2. So remember that this is your information. Further, what do they give me? They've given me gas constant. Done. Further, they've given me molar mass. That means what formula should I use? Two things are given to me. C can be further written as C is equal to N by V RT. Yes. This can further be written as number of moles W2 by M2 into 1 by V into R into T. Why am I using this? This quantity is given, this quantity is given, so till here. That means if you write the formula till here, then only you'll get marks. This, no, not this is also not the correct formula, this is the correct formula. Now let us write the given data for us. Yes. So what is W2? W2 is 2.5 into 10 to the power of minus 2 grams. What is M2? Yes, given to us is 174 gram per mole. Yeah, what is the volume given to us? Volume given is 2 liters. Gas constant value given to us is 0.028. K inverse, mole inverse. Please copy along with the units. Then temperature. How much is temperature given to us? Temperature given to us is only 25 degree. Now remember, always you have to convert that into Kelvin temperature by adding with 273, which makes it to 298 Kelvin. Now the data is ready. Now substitute in that formula directly. Now come back and substitute. Pi is equal to W2 is 2.5 into 10 to the power of minus 2. Molar mass given is 174. Volume given is 2. Gas constant given is 0.0821. Temperature is 298 Kelvin. Please don't forget to add to 273. When you solve this, you get an answer of 1.76 into 10 to the power of minus 3. Unit for atmospheric pressure, that is osmotic pressure, is atmosphere. So what are you going to do? You will find the answer. You will write. And finally, most important thing, you have to end your answer writing in this way. What should you write? What did they ask me? Determine the osmotic pressure of a solution. So osmotic pressure of the solution is 1.76 into 10 to the power of minus 3 atmospheres. That's it. This is how you're going to write. This is a complete way of solving the numerical, where you'll be getting full 3 marks for this.